I need to know the situation or the conditions of my son. It is so painful. I'm in deep pains inside of me.
In 2007, Andrew Mbang was watching a football match with his friends when he was arrested by the police.
School days. This is Andrew.
13 years later, his whereabouts remain unknown.
If police have killed my son, let them tell me. And tell me the offence he has committed.
After Andrew's disappearance, patients left Port Harcourt, but now she's back. She presented her case at a panel of inquiry a few weeks ago and is hoping that tomorrow she will get the answers she's been looking for.
I feel confident that I will get justice tomorrow.
It's the day of the hearing, and Patience and her sister Gift are eager to arrive early. 29 of Nigeria's 36 states set up these panels in response to the NSAR's protests. Their aim is to investigate allegations of police brutality and provide answers to thousands of families whose loved ones have been brutalised, killed, or like Andrew, are missing. Like many of the other petitioners present, Patience is relieved she has an opportunity to present her case, but it's a lengthy process. Many people spend hours waiting for the chance to share their stories, while some are told to come back another day.
Gentlemen, you please bear with us. We don't send any notice. 7 out of 10, I think we've tried. One to rest. So we'll call it a day. In other words, we're rising for the day until tomorrow.
It's about 4:30 and we've been here since 8 a.m. and your case hasn't been heard yet. How are you feeling, Patience?
I feel tired anyway. Well, there's nothing I can do. I think this is part of life. This is Nigerian style. We are used to it.
Patience and Gift will now return home, hopeful that tomorrow will be their day. After an anxious night, Patience and her sister are back at the panel hearing, and after 4 hours of waiting, she's called to the stand for cross-examination.
He was watching football match.
What offense was
he? I don't know.
Shortly after, her case is closed by the panel.
Been able to close our case, and so we are waiting the commission's recommendation. But what I do not know is the time.
Okay, thank you very much. Yes. God bless you.
Now all she can do is wait.
So how are you feeling after what we just heard at the panel today?
I've been waiting for 13 years now, so I don't think my still waiting will be in vain. God is going to avenge for me.
And what's next for you now?
I will go back to my place. If they call me, I will come back. By God's grace, I will come back.
Before she starts the 3-hour journey back to where she now lives, Patience takes us to her old neighbourhood. She rarely comes back here. The memories are too painful, but all her old friends are clearly happy to see her.
Yeah.
Hey! Well done. Are you okay? This is the place that we were living. The last place that Andrew was arrested. This is the place. I was running a restaurant here with other things, businesses. He loves playing football.
So he used to play here?
Yes.
Patience is ready to return home to wait for the panel's recommendation, which will be published at the end of the inquiry process. But as her fight for justice nears its end, elsewhere in the city, another may just be starting. News has broken of a young man allegedly shot and killed by the police because he refused to pay a 100 naira bribe. That's less than 30 cents. Authorities say the officer in question has been arrested and the case will soon be heard in court. Nigerians have reacted with outrage at the news, which shows that despite weeks of protests and panel hearings across the country, the fight against police brutality is far from over.